Hi, my name is Johnny Vaught, and this is The Review, where I review the latest and the greatest movies. This week, we will be discussing Deadpool 2. Before we get to that, just a little bit about me and the show. I'm a lifelong lover of movies. I certainly appreciate going into a movie knowing as little as I can, other than I should probably be excited. So here on The Review, I will always do my best to avoid all major spoilers. And in Deadpool 2, there are plenty of surprises that I really appreciate everybody doing a great job of not spoilering. I was watching it in the theater and just being like, oh my gosh, that and that and that. I thought it was a super cool movie, definitely loaded with a lot of Easter eggs. Now, here at The Review, I will offer a recommended viewing guide. I will recommend that you go and see it, stay home and stream it, or skip it. Now, for Deadpool 2, I am definitely going to recommend that you go and see it. This movie has a lot of big, wide-open scenes, really cool effects, and I just think that it did an awesome job of making itself a really big movie, something that definitely justifies the cost of going to the movie and absolutely has the experience enhanced by seeing it on a big old screen with a lot of people. Definitely feel the energy from the crowd and just enjoy this movie. Now, Deadpool 2 is rated R. They definitely made sure that it was rated R. Like the first Deadpool movie, there is some really gratuitous rated R content. And I think that they did that to make this an adult movie, to make it a movie that the audience had grown up enough to be able to see. The superhero wave definitely started long enough ago that the people who were younger then are older now and are ready for rated R comic book content. And Deadpool definitely came through with it. I thought that it was really reminiscent of Logan, how they definitely earned their rated R with violence. I didn't ever think that it was too much. It was definitely rode that line of being almost absurd. There's definitely a lot of absurd stuff in Deadpool 2. One of the things that I really appreciate about the Deadpool character as portrayed by Ryan Reynolds is that he clearly loves it. There's a lot of content out there about how Ryan Reynolds is a real champion for the character and the movies, and it really shows in his performance. There's so many moments in this movie where even he acknowledges that he is having a really good time portraying this character. It seems totally just loving the energy that he puts into it. And the characterization is just an absolute hoot. The Deadpool character does do a technique called breaking the fourth wall. Imagine Zach Morris back in Saved by the Bell, where he will direct a camera directly, explain what's going on and give his thoughts on the story as almost like a step back and like look at the forest rather than just the trees situation. I love that. You almost never see it in films. It is something that I went into Deadpool 2 expecting. It lived up to it. I thought it was super funny. The other characters in the movie all did a great job. Like I did mention, there are an incredible amount of Easter eggs and cameos. I certainly won't be spoiling any of those right now. So from the preview, you know that you can expect to see Josh Brolin in this movie portraying Cable. I was really surprised to see that his character was listed as Nathan Summers / Cable, because he may be Nathan Summers, but he was only portrayed as Cable. I thought that it was kind of funny that they talked about that. Just a little digression. Cable is the son of Cyclops and Jean Grey. Scott Summers, he's Nathan Summers. That was never addressed in the movie, and they didn't ever call him Nathan, so I thought that it was funny that he was billed that way. So Cable, great job. Definitely had some funny fourth wall breaking, talking about how he doesn't look exactly like in the comics. Loved that. I think that you will too. From the first movie, the love interest, Morena Baccarin, Vanessa, again, in the trailers, no spoilers. Loved her in that movie. Loved her in this movie. Loved her the most probably in the first season of Homeland. That was a really great character. And also, we were discussing it before the show, if you have never seen the show Firefly, treat yourself. It's available. It's one season, gone too soon. They ended up making a movie of it afterwards. She was great in that too. Check it out. It's a joy. It's a space western. It's fantastic. TJ Miller is in this movie also. Really definitely loved him on Silicon Valley. Have heard some things about TJ Miller, the person, that I didn't absolutely love. Pretty awful stuff. But TJ Miller, the performer, the character in this movie, just like TJ Miller, super funny, happy to have him be a part of the cast. Julian Dennison is a younger actor. It's only one of his few large movie roles. He was fantastic in Hunt for the Wilder People. That was a great movie. It's available to stream right now. He is awesome in this movie. He is an actor from New Zealand, and I think he leans into his accent a little bit, and that's super funny. Zazie Beetz, who has been fantastic on Atlanta, is in this movie. And her character is just somebody that I did not expect to see in this movie. It was super awesome. I thought that they did a great job having fun portraying her superpower. That was really awesome. And 100% super important. You need to stay for the end of the credits for this movie. I feel like at this point, a lot of times in superhero movies, we expect to have to stay towards the end. I actually have an app on my phone that I love that tells you if you do need to stay towards the end. And I've never seen them write, if somebody is leaving the movie theater, grab them and make them stay. I thought that it was awesome. I definitely want to let you know to stay towards the end. I do think that it would help if you went into this movie familiar with Deadpool 1. I don't think it's 100% necessary as long as you understand who Ryan Reynolds is, because if you are familiar with him enough, you'll be able to enjoy it. You should probably see Deadpool beforehand. I know that there were some double features. You're not gonna be completely lost if you haven't seen Deadpool 1. It will help, and it is a good movie. But for Deadpool 2, I'm gonna recommend that you go and see it in the theaters, bring some friends, get some popcorn, get ready to laugh and have a really good time, and in a adult comic book movie. My name is Johnny Vaught, and this is The Review.